Jurassic World Rebirth is finally here. The latest entry into the franchise transports us to Ile Saint Hubert. This new island, located in the tropical Atlantic near South America, is home to neglected InGen clones that have established a sort of bizarre ecosystem here in the absence of humans. Along with new dinosaur species like Titanosaurus and radical remakes of old favorites like Spinosaurus, Jurassic World Rebirth introduces something else: mutated failed hybrids that lean harder into body horror than anything we've seen before. And perhaps the most unsettling of the bunch is the Mutadon, an unholy, twisted InGen concoction of Raptor and Pteranodon. So what kind of genetic tampering did InGen do leading up to this monstrosity? Let's break it down and speculate on what went into the DNA of this hybrid to make it look the way it does. Before we deconstruct these horrid hybrids, let's first get to know the Mutadons a little better. The Mutadons are large terrestrial predators that compete with the island's raptors. These creatures stand at around 6 to 7 feet tall and measure at 16 feet long. They weigh approximately 550 pounds, making them about as heavy as an African lion. Given their size and stature, they most likely play the niche of a mid-sized predator, while the larger carnivores like Spinosaurus fill the apex predator roles. Mutadons have paper-thin wings draped in slightly translucent skin. They have a mouthful of needle-like teeth, and their jaws end in a hooked pseudobeak. The Mutadons have an oversized throat pouch attached to their rather stout necks. They appear to have longer legs than the raptors and still retain the iconic sickle claws. When walking, the Mutadons keep their wings folded up almost like birds. However, when running, they need to stretch their wings out in order to maintain balance. Mutadons can also move quadrupedally whenever they are in tight spaces. The Mutadon's rather awkward anatomy and apparent lack of higher intelligence would make it harder for them to tackle larger prey. Instead, they most likely go for baby dinosaurs or for smaller species like aquilops. They can also use their larger size to intimidate raptors and scare them away from kills, letting the smarter predators do all the heavy lifting. So, now that we've gotten to know these hybrids a little better, and understand their role in this ecosystem, let's take a crack at what DNA cocktail helped birth these monstrosities. As with most InGen hybrids, building the Mutadon likely began with fragmented DNA, this time pulled from both Velociraptor and Pteranodon. Now, the InGen version of these animals are extremely different from their real-life counterparts, and we'll explore how they stack up to the fossil record in future videos. For now, based on the anatomy of the Mutadon, we can see that InGen raptors are the primary influence. Of course, throwing in raptor and pteranodon DNA alone might not have been enough to build a genome for these beasts. No InGen hybrid would be complete without some plump, juicy amphibian filler. Just like with the other dinosaur clones, frog DNA was likely used in building this genome. Now onto the wings and fingers. Unlike pteranodons, the Mutadons have extra partial webbing between their fingers. There aren't any dromaeosaurid species that have these almost dragon-like wings and web skin between digits, but there is another dinosaur species that did. Yi Chi. This late Jurassic dinosaur had bat-like wings and a bizarre rod of bone extending from its wrists. While most of this animal's body was covered in feathers, small patches of preserved wrinkled skin showed that a fleshy membrane stretched across the fingers and rod to form the wings. The inclusion of Yi Chi DNA could explain the additional webbing and further contribute to the genetics that helped build the Mutadon's wings. Yi Chi is basically the closest thing evolution has given us to a dragon. And while they didn't breathe fire, they were still amazing animals in their own rights. The Mutadons have a gnarly set of overlapping teeth, unlike anything seen in the raptors. Furthermore, pteranodons lack teeth entirely, so we know those aren't coming from that side of the genome. A possible candidate for the hybrid's bizarre set of dentures could be another species of pterosaur, Sierodactylus. This early Cretaceous flying reptile had a mouthful of long, needle-like teeth that angled forward like barbs. Now in real life, all of these extinct animals contributing to the Mutadon's genetic makeup so far were either feathered or covered in pycnofibers. On the contrary, the Mutadons are featherless fiends covered from head to toe in scales. In addition to the featherless InGen raptors, this could also be thanks to the DNA of a couple of reptiles combined with frog DNA, possibly suppressing feather development. Based on the hybrid's striking coloration, we're going to assume that DNA from the Argentine black and white tegu was used. This large South American lizard has a beautiful dark and white spotted pattern not too dissimilar from the hybrid. And finally, the Mutadon has a line of bumpy osteoderms running down its back. We're going to assume that DNA from a unique Triassic marine reptile known as Erythmorhippus was used to help contribute to this trait. This bizarre creature from early Triassic China was basically the Triassic equivalent of a platypus. Now, the Mutadon didn't inherit its goofy face or flippers, or any of its aquatic adaptations, but it did inherit its osteoderms, which helped further aid to its intimidating flair. So, there we have it, our speculative breakdown of the genetic makeup of the Mutadons. Again, none of this is officially canon to the franchise. This is just a fun way to explore the science fiction behind these hybrids. Let me know in the comments below what you guys think about the Mutadons. While I personally prefer real and more scientifically accurate approaches to dinosaurs, this fictional beast has actually kind of grown on me. Perhaps spending all this time drawing and animating it helped me to like it a little more. But for now, I'm still gonna pick my feathered velociraptors over silly movie monsters. And who knows, it's entirely possible that even more genetic material from both extinct and extant species was used in making this hybrid. Where did they get their large neck pouches from? How does such a bizarrely proportioned animal actually move? Why do they kind of act dumb in some scenes? So many important questions. Now, if you want to see more animated content about real dinosaurs, be sure to check out my previous video on Carnotaurus. Here we compare the Jurassic World version to the real-life animal, and let's just say that the design team nearly nailed it. As always, thanks for watching.